Good evening, children. Today I'm going to read a story to you that's called Little Red Riding Hood. I'm sure you're all familiar with this story, but you may look at the new pictures and hear it once again. Once upon a time, there lived a little girl called Little Red Riding Hood. She was called Little Red Riding Hood because she wore a red cape and a red hood. One day her mother told her, "Little Red Riding Hood, your granny is very ill. Take her some cake and biscuits to eat for tea." And there were two instructions her mother gave her. One, do not stop on the way and do not speak to strangers. "Okay," said the Little Red Riding Hood. And off she went. Now, Little Red Riding Hood's granny lived on the other side of the forest. When she reached the middle of the forest, Little Red Riding Hood saw some beautiful flowers that smelled very good. So she thought of picking up some flowers for her granny. Granny sure will be happy to have them in her room. It'll bring a bit of brightness. That was the first instruction she disobeyed. Remember, her mother had said not to stop on the way, but she did. And as she bent down to pick up the flowers, someone horrid, big and bad jumped out from behind the tree. "Hello, little girl," said the big bad wolf. Little Red Riding Hood froze in horror, looking at his big teeth and big eyes and big ears. She couldn't utter a word. The wolf asked her, "What is your name, little girl?"
My name is Little Red Riding Hood."
Now that was the second instruction she disobeyed. Remember, her mother had said not to speak to strangers on the way? But here she is, speaking to one.
"And where are you off to, little girl?"
I'm going to my granny's house to give her some cake and biscuits for tea. You see, she's not well."
"Oh, that's a good deed. And where does your granny live, little girl?"
My granny lives on the other side of the wood."
"Okay, bye then."
"Bye-bye," said Little Red Riding Hood. And the wolf ran off.
Do you think the wolf ran away to the woods?
No. He went to granny's house and he knocked on the door.
Now, Granny was so ill, so she said in a weak, feeble voice, "Who's it?" Now, the wolf took out Little Red Riding Hood's voice and said,
"It's me, Granny, Little Red Riding Hood. Mama sent you some cakes and biscuits for tea. May I come in?"
"You may, dear. The door is open. I'm too weak to walk."
The wolf opened the door, went in, and gobbled Granny up.
"Look, there Granny is sitting in the wolf's tummy. And her two white chotis are hanging out from the wolf's mouth."
"Oh, poor Granny."
Then what do you think the big bad wolf did? He ran to Granny's room, took out Granny's nightgown, put her little bonnet around him, wore her spectacles, tied an apron round his big waist, picked up the blanket, jumped onto the bed, and covered himself up, waiting for his delicious meal. Which is going to be here soon. Yum, yum. After a while, Little Red Riding Hood came to Granny's house, and she knocked on the door. Now the cunning wolf took out Granny's voice.
"Who's it?" Granny, Little Red Riding Hood. Mom has sent you some cakes and biscuits for tea since you're not well. May I come in?
Yes, you may, dear. I'm too weak to walk. The door is open.
All right. As soon as the Little Red Riding Hood entered, she looked at her granny and froze. Looks like my granny is really unwell. She looks so different.
She looks quite ugly.
So she looked at the wolf and said, "Oh, granny, what big eyes you got." "So that I can see you better, my dear. Why don't you come closer?" Little Red Riding Hood hesitantly went closer and she looked at Granny's ears.
"Oh, Granny, what big ears you've got." "So that I can hear you better, my dear. Why don't you come closer?"
And then she noticed the big, sharp, ugly yellow teeth. And she says, "Oh my God, Granny, what big and sharp teeth you have got. So that I can eat you, you silly girl. Ha! The granny's there in my tummy and you're going to be next, going to join her. I'm not your granny. I'm the big bad wolf. I met you in the woods. Do you remember?" Little Red Riding Hood began to scream, "Oh, it's the big bad wolf. He's eaten up my granny. Help me. Someone help me." Just then, a woodcutter was passing by and he peeped in through the window and saw that the little girl was being chased by the big bad wolf. Both of them were going, "Pakra pakri," little in the front, the big bad wolf behind. And like a superhero, the woodcutter swooped in through the window and with his one blow off of the axe, he chopped the wolf into two. And look who jumped out. Granny, yippee. So now, the basket of goodies, the cakes and biscuits and tea, were shared by all three of them. Granny, the Little Red Riding Hood, and the kind, brave woodcutter. I hope you enjoyed the story, children. Tell your moms to put it on and you can hear it anytime, all the time. Bye. See you next week. Mwah.